Welcome back, it's Minecraelix here, and today we're going to do something different. We're going to play Minecraft Classic Survival Test. So what this is basically Minecraft in 2009, the earliest survival version of Minecraft. And I'm basically starting a new series, however, this will be only a one episode series because you cannot save the game in this version. So basically when I'm going to play until I die. That's what I think I'm going to do. So now, I'm going to just generate a new level here. Let me just make it huge. There's not even a menu. Like, you can't... There is no main menu. That's how old it is. Alright, we have generated a huge map. And also, one thing is that, like, there's not even an inventory. You do not have an inventory. And you cannot drop items as well. And what's even more is that there's not a sun. It's always daytime. But mobs can spawn even during daytime because it's always day, and the only food to eat are these brown mushrooms. So, excuse me. So what I'm gonna do now is I think I'm gonna get some wood, just like any Minecraft player would. Since of course getting wood is the first thing that you do in any survival game, but however it's not. You don't have to get wood for survival test because there's no crafting in the game. So, like, literally there's no crafting. So, when I break trees, I just get planks. And when I break them, I don't get anything. So, what I'm thinking is that I could build a house out of these planks. But I would like my house to be out of cobblestone. And you don't need a pick to mine. You could just mine with your, hand, which is pretty interesting. And you also have a score, like, up on the top right-hand corner. It said score. I currently have a score of 10 because I killed a pig. And you also get score, you get much bigger, like, scores added to you. I think it's, like, 300 for killing a spider or zombie or something. Anyway, so, down there where it says arrows, you have only two... Like, you only have two ways of hurting mobs. Is it just by using your hand, or you can use arrows. And you could just shoot, like, you don't need to have a bow. You could just shoot by tab, like right here. I'm pressing tab, and then I can pick back arrows. I'm just shooting. And you could shoot infinitely, picking up like them like that. Which is very interesting because, well, it's kind of like an in-game quiver, kind of like what they added in 1.9. When they added the quiver, they kind of returned it back to survival test because there's only two development versions of Minecraft. And I mean, there's only two versions of Minecraft that have quivers, and that's survival test and 1.9. So I get one cobblestone per every stone block that I break. There are also ores, which can be mined with hand as well. Now, I don't want to bore you guys out, so I think what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and find some mobs, and this is exactly what I was looking for. So, I already know what's going to happen when we get this iron. So, we get iron blocks instead of getting iron ore blocks or iron ingots. We just get iron blocks, and I think it's just for, like, to make it more appealing to look at. And these ores are, like, they're completely huge. Like you could get, like, a hop, I think it's up to, 100 iron ore per vein or something like that. There's definitely more than enough iron and coal needed in this game. And the thing with coal, when you mine, you don't actually get coal blocks, since coal blocks weren't implemented in the game until, like, I think 1.6 or 1.7 official release. So instead, you actually get half slabs when you mine coal. That is actually pretty interesting, because, I mean, how are you supposed to get half slabs when mining coal? Yeah, the game wasn't very straightforward. It was obviously in heavy development, and it was an unfinished version. And what's even more, it was just a survival test. Most of the people that played the game in just creative, and that was basically the only game mode that existed in Classic up until survival test. Anyway, let's just mine just a bit more iron blocks. And the fun thing with this is you can actually stack items, I think, up to 99. You don't even have to, like, you can exceed the 64 stacking limit. And also one thing I forgot to say is that you actually spawn in with 10 TNT, and you can't craft TNT or get it in any way. You can only spawn with it, and I just spawned with 10 TNT. Also, another interesting thing is that actually creepers blow up after you kill them. Creepers can actually, like, when the creeper comes up to you, it just starts hitting you. I don't know how, like, a creeper doesn't have arms, but they just thought, oh yeah, well, we're gonna have the creeper hit the player. But it only, like, blows up, and the blowing up textures are very interesting. Like, it looks like kind of like a leaf-breaking texture, I don't know. And here's the coolest part, guys. See, I have, like, 78 blocks in one stack. That is pretty epic. So let's go kill some sheep over here. And, oh yes, sheep ate grass, and grass could regrow. That was already added in the game. And also, you could also replant trees. Let me just get a sapling here just to show you. Ouch, ouch. Yes, this is basically, let's see. Okay, yeah, yes, yes, it up by 100. Our score went up, because now it's 100. Yeah, good thing that there's a lot of pigs. This is the bad side in the game. At first, it seems so easy, like, just mining by yourself, but then there's, like, always mobs. I always gotta watch my back out. And also, the thing is interesting that the recent update with 1.9, it actually really reminds me of Survival Test, because they added a quiver in 1.9, just like Survival Test has a quiver. And what they also added is they added a zombie, like, mob animations, like, when they hit you, their arms kind of go up. That's what they added in 1.9, and this actually existed in Survival Test for a short amount of time. If I'm able to find a zombie, I could show you guys that, like, when the zombie hits me, like, there's basically a zombie animation texture where it's hitting you, and looks like we got some spiders, ouch, and oh my god, were they fast, okay. Oh, looks like they couldn't climb, huh? Where are you spiders now? Yep, killed them all. Let me go get some more of that. Shrooms, I need some more shrooms. And the hard part with this is that if, wow, that sheep is inside the block. And the interesting, and oh yes, guys, looks like we got a sapling. We planted the sapling, it's going to grow up to a tree that existed way back then. And looks like we got some skellies there. Skellies are very useful. Because, let's see, because they actually gave you arrows when you needed a refill on arrows. Ouch. Wow, this is some pretty serious stuff here. Oh my god. Yeah, yes, there's like zombie animation textures. Yeah, zombies were really difficult. They actually like came at you. Now they're just slow. Alright, let's see. Let me just eat a bit more. Let me kill that. It's very hard to get arrows in the game. Actually, the skellies, they do drop arrows. Let me see. Ouch. Ouch. There's quite a bit of them. And also, one thing with this is interesting is that you can't pick up arrows shot by skeletons because... yeah, we just died there. So what I thought is that before actually ending the episode, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just build a house and get all of the obtainable blocks. I kind of lied there when I said that I'm going to end the episode when I die, because, I mean, it's only 8 minutes. I want to make the Let's Play a bit longer than that. I think what I'm going to do is I want to get some half slabs to show you guys. Go find some coal somewhere over here, show you, I also wanted to show you guys how creepers, look like, how the world border looks like, let's see. And, oh yeah, guys, if you're wondering how I got, Survival Test on my, and, oh yes, this is exactly what I wanted. Exactly what I wanted. So, there, actually, you could mine, the speed of mining wasn't affected by, if, like, I'm floating in the middle of the, water here. So if you're wondering, and also if you're wondering how I got this version onto my launcher, I actually like downloaded from some YouTuber online. I can give a link and do a tutorial if I get enough like people asking in the comment section. However, just to say for the record, I got this from some person who like downloaded who uploaded it to Mediafire or something. and they just put a link in their video for the download link, and I just decided to download it. And oh yes, this is one thing that only existed in the oldest versions of Minecraft, such as Classic, flooded caves. As you can see, there was no water currents. One block of water could flood the whole map. Like when I break this block, usually in Minecraft it would just kind of flow from the source block, but this didn't have any source blocks. So anyway, let's just build a... Real quick, let me just build a golden house. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Oh, let's just make it tiny. Ah, yeah, even then we're gonna run out. Let's just fill this in. It's gonna look super ugly, but it's gonna showcase all the blocks in the map at the time. Let's see, let me just... Oh, wow, you could even plant... How smart, you could plant roses on metal. Yeah, Minecraft was definitely in its development. So, anyway, this is how you set off TNT. You just left-click, and then you just press on it, and... It just... It, like, the blowing up textures are very interesting. They're, like, much different than from others. So, what I want to do now is I want to find some creepers and also coal, so I can show you guys how creepers explode and how coal is derived. And here are the, like, the when... Ouch. I think there might be someone behind me right now. So, anyway... When the zombie approaches me, like, its arms kind of go up, and they actually implemented this in the 1.9 update, which is very interesting. They kind of modeled it after survival test, kind of going back to old versions of Minecraft. So this time I picked a small world, so as you can see, there's the world border over there, there's the world border over there. Let me see. And of course, there's no sun, there's just light, just whatever. I wonder if there were, like, commands or mods to get more blocks and stuff, so let me see. Yeah, I hope I don't get killed by this. And oh my god, where are the zombies fast? I wish zombies were like that right now. Like, even hardcore mode is much easier, compared to survival test. So let me just break that to show you. Yeah, you just get iron blocks. They look like this, and they look like this, until, I think, late alpha. I think they changed the texture of, iron blocks in, I think, alpha 1.2.0 or 1.2.6 or something like that, around the time when they added the nether. So the iron blocks look like this for quite a long time. Yeah, looks like we're not getting much monster spawnage. I really want to find some creepers. I don't know why they're not spawning. Well, at least I just want to find some coal just so I can show you guys how half slab looks like. And yes, you could get damage from falling, and caves did exist. It's just that they were, like, deeper underground. There weren't as much cave entrances as they are now, and the cobblestone looked like this for quite a long time, until I think beta 1.7 or beta 1.6 or something like that. Yeah, world generation was drastically different. There were, like, these ditches here. I think it was to make it much more difficult to, like, fend off zombies, because they could easily like gang up on you and easily kill you. Well, same goes as an alpha if you're playing on, like, hard difficulty. And oh my god, like, where's all the coal? So anyway, I think I could just mine for a bit now. Here, what I want to do is, so I'm, oh yes, this is exactly what I wanted. So when I mine the coal, it actually takes a very long time to mine coal, much longer than it takes to mine regular stone. However, this kind of reminds me how it is in Minecraft Alpha and in Minecraft 1.9. Coal requires about the same time to mine as in this version right here. And what's interesting is that you guys are seeing this in full screen resolution. You guys can full screen this if you're watching this on YouTube. However, if for me, I cannot full screen this, because then it's gonna mess it up. So I have to, like, look into a small box, kind of like an emulator. And what's interesting is that, as you can see, like, the textures of the half slabs were weird. Like, this looks like stone, but when you pick it up, it's just half slabs. And this is how half slabs look like, just like the half slabs in 1.9 and 1.8, and they basically, they're kind of the same, at least, like, for some reason I can't place one here. So when I broke one, it just broke two. However, it had this, like, texture up top right here as well. So that's how it looks like, and using these half slabs, you could also build, very easily build, a staircase. So, like, when I'm, say I don't want to, like, jump up every time I'm mining, and this is exactly what I'm talking about. I broke one block, and it flooded the whole cave. So anyway, let me just demonstrate this up top so it'd be easier to see. Just place a block here. So yeah, anyway, you could just make these, kind of, I kind of messed up there. You can make these kind of like staircases, which is really cool. Yeah, right here. Kind of like this, like I don't have to jump up to go up here, and that's how you can make staircases before stairs were added. So I think we gone over everything except creepers. Oh, and yeah, gravel existed too. However, flint didn't exist. It was much quicker to break than now. And basically, how it looked like the world border, it's just bedrock. And yes, bedrock existed. And I think the last thing I'm going to do before ending the Let's Play is I'm going to go to the highest point on the map possible. I think I have enough blocks for that. So let me see. The height limit was pretty low. Nope, not yet. And the F3 menu doesn't work, so if I press F3, it actually doesn't do anything, and I just saw those sheep spawn, and sheep could spawn anywhere. They could also spawn, like, on the grass. And what's interesting is that, see, like, when I jump up, I place the block, but it's actually taking away the blocks for me, but it's not being placed. So this is obviously the world height limit. And this is how a small world looks like. I just decided to generate a small one. But in the first one that I got killed, it was actually a huge map. Let me just demonstrate when I go escape. This is the menu. This is basically the menu. It had these, like, fog renders, and it's just completely funny. I mean, like, what, tiny? Like, you can't even see anything. Anyway, far. Let me just go to far again. It had, Oh, you could show frames per second. That's basically F3. Yeah, I'm getting really good frames per second. And you could also press F to get fog. And we're getting such epic frames per second here, somewhere around 1,000. Anyway, I think when you press respawn, you can't press R to respawn. I think in the earlier versions, you could press G to spawn a human mob. So, where you could say, save file, however, it opens up, like, a filing system for you, but it's actually broken. You cannot save maps on here. I have tried. So, when you just generate new, just huge, and it did not have any menu, like I said before, you couldn't, like, press E, and this is how a huge world looks like. It has borders, however. And it looks like we got some creeper spawns, exactly what I've been looking for. And this is basically what I'm going to do right before the episode ends. And the creepers kind of looked weird. Obviously, they were generated by a bug. I mean, they only lit up. And look, see, it can the creeper can actually hit me. Like, it only explodes when I kill it. Only then when it explodes. So, it's actually a pretty new concept that creepers... And basically, mob spawnage was completely... stupid. Like, there are places where there's, like, no mobs at all, and other places where there's a lot of mobs, like, and actually, they've had some pretty powerful blasts here. Ouch. Anyway, wow, that's a pretty high score, just over such a small amount of time. So anyway, like, you couldn't, set any difficulty, so mobs would only spawn. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this Let's Play. In this episode, I start this Let's Play and end the series, because like I said before, I can't save or load maps. So I hope you enjoyed. If you got up to this point, thank you very much. So this is Minecraylix, and see you all in the next Let's Play or the next video tutorial that I do. Anyway, see you in the next video.